Hi everyone! Welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion React Charts using the Create React App command. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add the chart component to a React app using the Syncfusion React Charts package and populate data. Then I will show you how to configure a chart with the title, legend, data labels, and tooltip. First, let's see the prerequisites to work with the React application. I'm going to create the app using Create React App toolchain and use VS Code as the editor, and then show the output in the Chrome browser. Now let me start to create a new application in Command Prompt using the npx create react app command and provide the app name, MyReactApp. I set the script version to template TypeScript. Next, navigate to the desired location and run this example using the npm start command. Now, I can edit the app.tsx page and show the Syncfusion chart here. Next, I open the project in VS Code and remove the default code snippets from the app.tsx file and styles from the app.css file and import the material theme style to apply it to the chart component. Then I install the chart package using the command npm install Syncfusion EJ2 React Charts. To start using the chart component, I import it from the EJ2 React Charts package and include the chart component tag. Now, I run my application. As you can see, the output displays the chart component with two axes, X and Y, and no data plotted on it. Now, let's see how to visualize the sales data in the chart for a particular year. To show data points in a chart, I need to bind data and connect those data points using series. In this application, I am going to use line series. As you know, the chart component is segregated into individual feature-wise modules, and you need to import the line series module from the chart package. Then inject the line series module into the chart component services. The next step is to include the series collection directive, which allows you to specify multiple series. For now, I define a single series using a series directive tag and include the series type as line. Let me explain how to populate a chart with data points. I can bind an array of JSON objects or an instance of the data manager to the chart using the datasource property. Then add the data.js file, where I will define the JSON object as sales data with two fields, month and sales. In the app.tsx file, I import the sales data from the data.js file and bind it to the data source property. After binding data, I need to set the XY axis to the series. I assign the month field to the X axis using the XName property and the sales field to the Y axis using the YName property. Since X axis in the JSON object contains categorized data, I need to configure the horizontal axis with category using the primary X axis property. To do so, I import category module from the chart package and inject it into the chart services. Then I assign the value type option as category. Look at the chart now, the data is plotted with line series and a categorized x-axis. You can also provide a piece of information about the data plotted in the chart by adding a title. Let's see how to provide a title to the chart, as well as to its x and y-axis. To provide the title to the chart, I include the title property and set its value to sales analysis. I set the title to the x-axis by including the title option in the primary x-axis property and set its value to month. To set the title to the y-axis, I include the primary y-axis property and assign the title as sales. Notice here, the title has been added to the chart, x-axis, and y-axis. Next, I will show you how to set a legend to the chart. A legend provides information about the series rendered in the chart. To enable it in the chart, I need to import the module legend from the chart package and inject it into the chart services. Then I include the legend settings property and enable the visible option. Then I specify the series name as sales to show it as the name for legend items. See here, the chart is rendered with the legend. You can also expand and collapse the chart series by clicking the legend. Now I will show you how to add data labels to improve the readability of the chart. To do that, I need to import the module data label from the chart package and inject it into the chart services. Then in the series directive, I add the marker property and set the data label visibility to true. I also enable the visibility of the marker. As you can see, the chart displays data points on the line series. Finally, I'll show you how to enable tooltips on the chart when showing data labels takes up too much space. To do so, I import the tooltip module from the chart package and inject it into the chart services. Then include the tooltip property in the chart and set the enable option value to true. Check now, tooltips are shown when I hover over the data points in the chart line series. Let me make a quick summary of what we have seen so far. I showed you how to add the chart component to a React app using the Syncfusion React Chart package. You have also learned how to set a title, legend, data label, and tooltip to the chart component. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.